sure that these are correct.
So these are all the stains I had.
What stains did you use?
We use SOX2 and OCT4.
At the UC Davis Institute for Regenerative Cures, it's not uncommon to find researchers working with stem cells that could provide cures for diseases like Huntington's, osteoporosis, and even cancer. What is uncommon are the researchers you see here.
The students in this program, first of all, take a class that teaches them about regenerative medicine, and then they get to work at the bench with mentors who are actually culturing cells.
Okay, so you want me to use this one and this one?
Yeah, that would be great.
These students are 16, 17, and 18-year-old high schoolers who won a rigorous year-long teen biotech challenge and were offered a very rare hands-on opportunity to work in one of the state's most advanced stem cell labs. It's a program sponsored by the California Institute for Regenerative Medicine that places high school students statewide with stem cell scientists at major universities.
By giving students the ability to come and intern, that opens their eyes and expands their knowledge on the different careers that this world has to offer, which is brilliant.
It helps you know beforehand, before you graduate from high school, that what kind of fields are available, and if you do pursue research, what it would entail.
These high school students have committed their entire summer vacation, 40 hours a week for 2 months, to working and learning here, giving up other summer activities they love for what they say is the opportunity of a lifetime. At 18, Mariam Bader was one of the oldest students in this group of 10. She was assigned to work on gene therapy for humans.
If anything, it actually made me want to do what I planned to more. It encouraged me. I really liked it. It actually showed me I could do a lot more than I had anticipated.
While many believe stem cell research is the future of medicine, it's no doubt these students are the next generation of scientists, doctors, and innovators who will someday turn stem cells into cures.
So they will be actually treating the patients, they will be developing the cures, and they will be hands-on manufacturing these cures.
Kristen Simoes for UC Davis.